February edition of the San Diego Home Garden Magazine is out. It shares how you can save money in the garden, but it's more than saving money. It's some really interesting hacks. Editor Wendy Generous is here to tell us a little bit about garden hacks. Yeah. Hi, Wendy. Good morning.
Good morning. How
now,
are you?
Now, I see, I'm doing great. Now, I see we have a banana that looks like it perhaps is beyond its usable use, right?
Yeah, but you don't have to throw these away. You can blend it or juice it and amend it into your soil for a potassium-rich treat for your plants. This hack is great. Take an old muffin tin and just press it into your soil, and it will give you perfectly spaced seeding.
Oh, wait a minute. So you put this into soft ground.
Yep.
And these things here
just
will make a hole in the dirt.
Yep.
And so then you have perfectly, so you go down your garden and you make these holes.
Perfectly spaced seeds.
That's awesome. That is fantastic. What a great idea.
Old plastic bottles can be used as mini greenhouses. When the weather starts to get cold, you can literally just put them over your plants in the garden and it will save them for the evening or
can
the frost.
Can they breathe in there? Do you need to put poke holes or anything?
You should
can
take
just
this
open
off.
That up. Okay. So then it won't freeze, right?
Right.
It'll just get cold, but it
won't.
Oh,
right.
That's
but it won't
so
freeze.
So this plastic does a protection thing.
Yep, it makes its own greenhouse.
Great.
You can reuse your coffee pods. You can use them.
This is like a Keurig, right?
Yep, use them as seed storage, or you can put the soil in them and start your plants in there before repotting them into a bigger pot.
Yeah, they start to pop out, you put them in the yard.
Exactly,
right?
Okay. And if you don't want to have to transplant, or you can plant seeds in here with soil and literally then just put them in the ground because the eggshells will decompose.
They're organic, right?
Yep, they're absolutely
so
organic.
You put a little bit of soil in there, your seed, and your soil, and tell me a little bit about the jagged edge.
So another way to use these is you can put these mostly in the soil and leave the jagged edge just poking out, and it will deter slugs and snails from coming into your garden.
How about that?
You can also mash these up and put them in your compost or in your mulch.
Very cool. Then
another hack we have is, so a problem that melons have or larger gourds is that they get fungus on the bottom when they hit the ground.
Yeah.
So you have a trellis, right? But in order to keep them strung up on the trellis, you can take old pantyhose, cut them like a foot up or so, and then you can just wrap them around. And you can either use, you know, clips like this, or you can use twine to cut them.
Yeah.
Yep. Or just tie it around your trellis, and you can do this for
and
your
that
gourds.
That doesn't
melons.
Affect its growth or anything like that, because this will expand, right?
Yep. Yep. Because this is all stretchable, elastic. So, yeah, you're not affecting its growth. You're just keeping it away from pests and fungus.
All right. Now, so this, I mean, look, this can all be done in very relatively small space.
And very cheaply.
And these hacks are found in this fabulous magazine, San Diego Home Garden.
Yep, and we have more. So check it out in the February
Oh, there's more
issue.
In there. Oh,
yep,
very
lots
cool.
More.
All right. Well, thanks very much. Appreciate you being here, Wendy. Check them all out. Do it at home. All right. As we continue here on Music.